morning. Welcome to Insiders. Well, population policy was the issue that dominated the media this week. Population and the related issues of immigration and asylum seekers. But it's worth reminding ourselves this was first put on the agenda back in October last year in precisely these terms.
By the year 2049, it is projected that our population will increase by some 60% to 35 million. This is a large increase. I passionately believe in a big Australia. I believe in a big Australia for three reasons. One, it is good for our nation's long-term national security. Two, it is the best means by which we can generate long-term prosperity for our people. And three, it is the best means to enhance the role that we would seek to play as Australians and the values we seek to bring to bear as Australians in the deliberations of the region and the world.
But this week's second round debate, placed against those sentiments, was virtually unrecognisable from the first. A very different debate altogether, very different sentiments expressed. This time, the background was a big increase in boat arrivals, and the spark was a coalition proposal that immigration numbers be cut.
I've recommended to the Governor-General the appointment of Tony Burke as Australia's first Minister for Population.
Population policy and developing a population strategy reaches into almost every corner of government policy.
Many Australians have legitimate concerns about the sustainability of different population levels in different parts of the country.
A government which has lost control of our borders is no fit government to give us the infrastructure we need to sustain the population of 36 million, which Prime Minister Rudd has just glibly endorsed.
We do not have a target of 36 million. It is not a government objective to get there.
So it's a projection, it's not a target. It's just a projection.
We're trying to move the deck chairs around when it comes to population.
It's very hard to have a population policy if you haven't got a border protection policy.
It's not simply a blanket immigration issue in that way at all.
It's a statement of the obvious that 300,000 net overseas migration average per year, Joe, is not sustainable.
Unless we take action to reduce the skilled migration, we will remain with this addiction forever.
So our population is going to grow regardless of what happens to immigration. Every day is a roller coaster,
but I'm the bump you never get over. The fact is, if you have large numbers of skilled migration feeding runaway population growth, this leads to declining housing affordability and increased prices for essentials like food and water and electricity and petrol.
There has simply not been enough housing built in this country over a long period of time.
You can trust Mr Rudd to let people in, but you can't trust Mr Rudd to give us the infrastructure we need to maintain people's living standards.
If we can't make those investments, that does put strain on our economy and on our environment.
I think part of the reason that we've got to this part of the debate has really been water.
We've got a current intake of 300,000. Now, all of those 300,000 use roads, catch buses, go on trains, drink water, all of those things.
It doesn't just go to water infrastructure. It goes to transport infrastructure and service delivery, including health.
They're not really confronting the big question, which is how many people should be coming.
Under Mr Rudd, we do not decide who comes to our country and the circumstances under which they come.
I think there are some dangers here for the opposition of trying to pull an election slogan from 2001 and hope that it will work for them again.
We can't just put out the welcome mat to everyone.
Here we are with asylum seekers, and once again, they chop and change depending on what they think will get that day's headlines.
Today I want to announce that the government is implementing an immediate suspension on the processing of all new applications from asylum seekers from Sri Lanka and Afghanistan.
This government is looking to stop a headline, not stop the boats.
The decisions that we've announced today have been taken very carefully, very thoughtfully and very methodically.
This is an admission by the government that its policies have failed.
The reality is, yes, that we have pressure on Christmas Island.
The government is determined to disrupt and deter people smuggling operations.
This is no solution. It's just an election fix.
We continue to treat people humanely. We continue to treat people with dignity.
This is policy making on the run, which is almost bound to fail.
Well, very shortly, the Deputy Prime Minister, Julie.